Consumer Reports' Paul Hope writes about grills, but he's also a trained chef. And while he loves a good pork shoulder on the grill, he says grilling can help you get your greens and so much more.
You can actually grill leafy greens just like you can anything else.
Grilled veggies like eggplant, zucchini, and onions are all good go-to grilled veggies, but you can expand your non-meat options to create interesting tastes and dishes, like grilled polenta with roasted tomatoes, or try grilling celery. Grill the celery until it's tender. Then you can toss it with some truffle oil, parmesan, and crushed red pepper. A new take on an already easy meal? Skewer pre-cooked meatballs and cook until heated through. They're fun and easy to eat, and try swapping in ground turkey for a new take. You can give soon-to-be-expired bread a new life on the grill, too. Just add a little olive oil, sprinkle with salt and pepper, and enjoy as is or top with some grilled veggies. Paul says not to shy away from fish either.
You start with a fish that's a little heartier and that's not going to flake and fall apart. Something like salmon, tuna are both great choices. You want to oil the fish itself and season it, but you also want to oil the grill grates right before you put the fish down.
If you want to splurge on a new grill, this $750 Weber Genesis tops Consumer Reports ratings for mid-sized grills.
So as a brand, Weber tends to do very well in our grill ratings, and they also come out near the very top of our annual surveys of reliability and owner satisfaction.
And if you're consistently cooking for a crowd, this large-sized grill from Monument Grills is a Consumer Reports Best Buy. It outperformed other large-sized grills that cost twice as much, if not more. Alina Machado, NBC 6 News.